Our lesson is about the statement of cash flows. We begin with one example. Learning is one company with a cash flow ending report ending December 31, 2016. So we have the cash flows from operating activities. We have first, on the first line is the net income with $250,000. And we add back the depreciation and the loss on sale of property and equipment. That's why 250,000 plus 20,000 and 10,000 is 280,000. Why do we add back the depreciation to the net income? Because as we have discussed, the net income composes of cash and non-cash transactions. In that, we have to adjust the net income into a pure cash transaction. Now that this depreciation is a non-cash transaction, we are going to add back the depreciation to make the 250 as cash, all cash items. So meaning this 250 will now become 270, okay? Because we excluded, we removed the effect of the depreciation which is deducted from the net income in the presentation of the statement of comprehensive income. And so with the loss on sale of property and equipment, what is the loss on sale? How do we get the loss on sale of property and how is it presented in the income statement? The income statement is deducting the loss on sale in its presentation. We have the operating income, and then we add the gain and less deduct the loss. So we have now the net income. So this net income includes the gain and deducted the loss. But again, this loss on sale of property, let's look at the investing activity. Investing activity proceeds from sale of furniture, no? Because from proceeds of sale of furniture, we gain, or we gain from sale, from the sale of furniture, if we have received cash more than the cost of the furniture. But if the proceeds from the sale of furniture, the cash received, is less than the cost of the furniture, we will incur a loss from the sale. Look at the term that we use, property and equipment. But in this case, in our example, there's no proceeds from sale of property and equipment. It's only a purchase. So we will use this item. Furniture na lang ang ating gamiting item. So this property and equipment, let's assume that this is a furniture, okay? Para ma-illustrate natin anong mangyayari. So this amount of 30,000 is the net amount of cash received. Now, how does the loss on sale of this furniture presented here in the investing activities? If we sell a furniture worth 40,000, let's say 40,000, let's credit our furniture. We have 40,000, and that the debit should always be in balance with the credit. And so we receive the cash proceeds of 30,000. So there is a difference of 10,000. And that is the loss on sale of furniture. Now, this loss on sale of furniture is reported here in our net income, in our statement of income statement. Kasama na siya dyan. So meaning, kasama siya sa net income, which is on the first line of the under operating activities, and kasama din siya dito sa proceeds from sale of furniture. Doon din natin nakikita, okay? Because furniture is 40, ibinawas na natin. We already deducted the 10,000 loss. That's why we get the amount of 30. So, included na ang proceeds from sale of furniture, which the loss is deducted dito sa investing activities, included pa rin ang loss dito sa net income ay may included ha, kasama na sa computation. Calculated amount of 250 is deducted by the amount of 10. No? So again, para hindi double, to make it only once na ma-present dito sa cash flow statement, alisin natin yung effect ng loss dito sa net income. Ibig sabihin, when we say remove the effect of the loss on sale of property, kung dati nabawasan ng net income, deducted, now we add back. Kaya nga add back ang gamit natin. Add back. So, dalawa yan. Depreciation is a non-cash transaction. Ang loss din is a non-cash transaction. Kaya nga hindi siya kasama sa cash. Okay. So, we have 250 at 20 at 10 is 280. How about when we have gain on sale? Isabay na natin. No? Gain on sale of property. Let's say, itong 10,000 na to, meron din tayong gain na another. Of course, when you sell a property like furniture, no? Minsan mo, ibang furniture na lang gamitin natin. Halimbawa, ibang furniture ang nasa example, ibang klase furniture. We have gain of 20. Diba? 20. So, yung 20 na yan, included na yung gain sa presentation ng income statement. Kasama na siya sa 250. So, kasama din siya dito sa investing. Paano naman siya? Ibahin naman natin. When we sell the furniture of worth 40,000, no? At sinabi natin may gain tayo because we receive cash of 60,000. So we have a difference of what? Yung amount ng gain na 20,000. But debit plus credit. So yung gain na to is already here in the proceeds from sale of furniture. Ibig sabihin, you receive the amount of 60, but your furniture is only 40,000, no? So you have a gain of 20. So madodoble again if we have presented the gain on sale of property included in the proceeds from sale of furniture and also included in the presentation of in the income statement. That's why nasama siya sa 250 na net income. So kung madodoble ang pagka-include ng gain, parehas na kasama ni i-negative natin, i-deduct naman natin. Unlike the loss, i-add back. Dito naman, i-deduct naman ang gain. So yun. Ang unang-unang natin is isusulat sa operating activities sa net income because this is the item that we have to reconcile. We have to adjust. We will make it as a pure cash transaction. Lahat lang lang i-include dyan. So we add back the non-cash transactions, depreciations or loss, or deduct naman yung gain, no? Whichever, kung ano ang nangyari sa sale. Now, we have here increase, decrease in trade and other receivables. Increase, decrease in trade and other payables. Net cash generated by operating. Madali lang to. So, if you are given a problem, ang titignan natin ay yung changes, kaya nga increase or decrease on the receivables. Bakit receivables saka payables? Because these are related, no, sa income or revenue and expense transactions na nasa income statement. Because sometimes, when we talk of accruals, diba? Or prepayments, deferrals, nandyan yung tinatanong natin, is there a cash here? May cash bang na-receive? May cash bang binayad? Like for example, accrued income. Pag may accrued income ka, you already have the income. But cash is not yet received. Diba? So already recorded or presented in the income. But already received. already presented in the net income, but the cash, is it a cash flow? So, kung hindi siya cash flow, yung in-increase ng receivables, because sabi natin, accrued income ay accrued income, income earned but not yet received. So, there is an increase in receivable, and yet this receivable pertains to non-cash transaction. So, yung sales or revenue increase the net income. But there is no cash. So, anong gagawin natin? If there is an increase in trade and other receivables, we deduct. No? Kaya nga ito, may 40 siyang dinidak because there is an increase in receivables. Bakit nag-increase ang receivables? Because of revenue on account. Kaya yung mga accrued income na yan, accrued rent, accrued subscription, accrued commission, di ba? Now, meron sinasabi naman ay decrease. Bakit bumababa ang receivables? Because of collection. Diba? So, if you collect the accounts receivable, you receive cash and nagde-decrease ang accounts receivable. Diba? So, there is a cash inflow. But, is this transaction affects the income statement and that the net income is affected? Hindi, di ba? Because these are both assets. Cash, increasing asset. AR, decreasing asset. There is a decrease in receivables. So, ibig sabihin, if there is a decrease in trade and other receivables, meaning yan, may collection. At kung may collection, may cash inflow. So, nakita ba yan sa net income? Kasama na ba siya? Included ba siya sa net income when you receive the cash for the collection of accounts receivable? Hindi, di ba? Hindi siya na-report dito sa net income included. So, ang gagawin natin, whatever is received na cash, i-add din natin. And when we decrease the trade and other receivables, we add naman instead of deducting. Kasi ang dinideduct ay yung increase. Sipin mabuti, no? So, yun ang effect ng mga changes in assets. Actually, these are current assets, no? Current assets yan. Sample lang ito. Meron pa tayong didiscuss sa baba para maintindihan ninyo mabuti. Okay? So, ito namang increase and decrease in trade and other payables. Nag-sample pa lang tayo. Bakit ba nag-i-increase ang payables natin? O kaya, bakit nag-de-decrease? Dito muna tayo sa decrease kasi decrease. Dito muna tayo sa increase. Bakit nag-i-increase ang other payables? Because we have expenses or purchases. If you purchase, may tinatawag tayong accrued expenses. Diba, liability siya? Because you incurred an expense without cash payment. Walang cash. Pero yung mga expenses ay na-report sa income statement and nabawas. Kaya ang net income mo ay so much lang. So meaning, there is no cash payment, non-cash transaction kapag nagkaroon ng increase in payables. Kaya nga may payables kasi walang cash kang binabayad eh. So doon pa lang dapat maintindihan na natin. So there is an increase in other payables. Doon pa lang tinitignan na natin sa galaw ng current liabilities if there is an increase in accounts payable, mayroong expenses na nabawas sa sales mo to arrive at the net income, lower net income. So ngayon, Walang cash na gumalaw, pero may expenses. So, ibig sabihin yung expenses na yan, dapat i-add back natin yung amount ng mga expenses because of we see in it every time it increase ang liability, the current liabilities, mayroong expenses na nabawas, not a cash transaction. So, i-add back natin kasi hindi nga siya cash transaction. Para mawalang effect nun, i-add back natin sa 250 yung 60. Now, doon naman tayo sa decrease. Why naman ang accounts other payables, trade and other payables, ay nag-decrease? Because there is a payment of the payables. So, ibig sabihin, mayroong cash payment. So, there is a cash transaction here. Let's look. Let's have AP as the debit and cash as the credit. So, meaning, nabawasan, decrease in accounts payable, there is a cash payment. This is a cash transaction. Pero pansinin, is this transaction affects the net income? Is this included in the income statement? Hindi. No? So, nandiyan lang yan sa balance sheet because this is a liability. The accounts payable is a liability. And the cash is an asset. Pero this is a cash outflow. So, you have to include it in the cash flow statement under the operating activities. Yeah? So, i-add natin, i-decrease din natin kasi nag-decrease ang cash. There is an outflow of cash. So, we have to include the decrease in cash in the net income. That's why the decrease in trade and other payables is also a decrease in the net income. We should deduct the amount that decreases the accounts payable. No? Accounts payable here is debited. It means accounts payable decrease. And it means that the accounts payable is paid with cash. So, decrease in accounts payable is a decrease in cash. So, we must deduct it to the net income because it is a cash transaction that is not reported in the income statement. Sundin mabuti, no? So, we have other explanations pa sa baba. Tuloy lang muna natin ito. Sa investing, again, we have purchases of property and equipment. All purchases of long-term assets included here, no? So, if you purchase, you pay the cash. There is no difference in this approach, in indirect approach, and the direct approach when we have the investing and financing activities. The same presentation lang yan. Ang nagkaiba lang sa indirect at sa direct ay yung UCI presenting the operating activities. Because indirect sa direct approach, we just present the gross receipts, gross payments. But here in indirect method or approach, we use or adjust the net income for the non-cash transactions because we have to show only the pure cash transactions. That's why we are removing the effect of non-cash transactions. Here naman sa increase and decrease of other trade, of trade and other receivables, trade and other payables, pag gumalaw sigurado yung mga current assets and current liabilities na yan, mayroong effect yan sa related income and expense that are reported in the income statement. Sa investing activities, na-discuss natin itong proceeds from sale of furniture, all the amount, actual cash amount lang ang ating isasama dito, no? If we say proceed, we must add the amount, not minus. Maraming nagkakamali dyan. So, again, yung payment at yung ating receipts, no? Kakaiba ang presentation here with the previous one. We just list, wala na siyang receipts dito sa title, hindi na tayo naglagay ng receipts or payments, no? Receipts, just listing right away the items and the amount, corresponding amount. Sa financing activities, still, we have all the borrowings from the bank, you receive or you pay, ganun din, no? Long-term loan from a bank is a proceed, no? Of 300,000. While additional investment from owner proceeds pa rin yan, 100,000. While the withdrawal, of course, we know that this is a cash outflow, 80,000. So we have a net cash generated by financing activities of 320. So if we are asked to give the net cash, net increase or decrease in cash and cash equivalents, we have to sum up the three activities, the amount of the three activities, 300,000 minus 120,000 plus 320,000, we have 500,000 as the net increase because this is positive amount. And we don't forget the previous amount of cash, which is now the beginning balance of the current year, 100,000. So we have a total of ending balance of 600. And the 600 is now equal to the amount of the ledger of your cash and equal to the amount of your cash in your statement of financial position, or what we call the balance sheet. Okay. So here in this topic, no, pinakikita pa rin yung indirect method. I-explain natin kung paano nangyari. Okay. First part is the operating activities. So, ang ibig sabihin, laging operating activities ang uunahin natin to present the operating activities sa cash flow. So, non-cash expenses like the depreciation are added back. No? Non-cash are added back. Depreciation, loss on sale, while non-cash revenues are deducted. Gain or loss on sale of non-current assets are deducted, added back. Meaning, ang gain ay nililess natin, dinideduct. Yung loss, ina-add back. Because the cash transaction is recorded under investing activities. No? Investing activities. Because this is not directly a cash, no? This is not direct cash transaction. Changes in current assets and current liabilities. Ito na yung pininiwanag natin kanina. In our balance sheet, you will see that the accounts receivable, accounts payable, will change in amount. It's either increased, will increase, or decrease. And that it should be adjusted for the amount of the net income because those changes are related to the income and expense reported in the income statement. So, increase in current assets. Ito ang rule, no? Pinakamadali para matandaan nyo. Pagka, current assets, yan. Pagka current assets ang pinag-uusapan, kapag nag-i-increase ang current assets, increase. Opposite ang mangyayari sa net income. Dapat daw, i-deduct. Minus na lang sign natin. No? Kapag naman decrease sa current assets, ito na lang ang inyong tandaan. Kaya lang, you have to know the principle or the reason why it should be deducted or added sa net income. Kapag naman decrease sa current asset, it should be added to the net income. Pag current assets ang pinag-uusapan, ha? When we have naman the current liabilities, kapag increase, it is also added to the net income. Pag naman decrease, it is what? Deducted. So dito sa current assets, opposite, no? Dito naman, hindi siya opposite. Go with the flow. If you have increases in your current liabilities, i-increase mo din yung net income. Yung decrease naman sa current liabilities, whatever current liabilities pa yan, kung hindi nyo pa maintindihan, basta i-decrease nyo din. No? Ang pinakamadaling reason dyan, dito sa current liabilities, no? Madaling isipin ang current liabilities. Bakit ba nag-i-increase ang liability? Because mayroong expenses, no? Bakit may decrease ang liability? Bakit may decrease? Because may bayad. So if you have bayad of cash, lumabas na yung cash. Diba? So if you have payment of cash, cash flow, and that cash out should be deducted sa net income kasi hindi nakita ng net income yan sa income statement niya nung nagbayad ka ng cash for the payables. Diba? Unahan pa natin yan. So again, let's go back to the accounts receivable. Increasing current assets is deducted to net income. Ito yun, no? Is deducted minus. This because accounts receivable increases revenue. Diba? Kaya lang naman lumilitaw o nag-increase ang accounts receivable because there is sales. There is a revenue. Or if you have revenue, it will increase your net income. Yes. But ito ang malaking ano, but malaking but. It is not a cash transaction. Dahil hindi cash transaction yung pag-increase ng accounts receivable, why nga ulit? Ang accounts receivable kaya lumilitaw kasi nga walang cash receipts. Kaya pag-increase ng accounts receivable, it is not a cash transaction, but it increases the revenue and eventually increases the net income. Not a cash transaction. Kaya naman, yung net income mataas because of the increase in net income, because of the increase in revenue, na hindi naman cash. So, deduct natin para maging totoo na yung net income ay puro cash. Bawas natin yung effect ng pagka-increase ng income because of the sales on account. Yan. Yun ang ibig sabihin niya. No? Ito namang prepaid expenses. These are, yung accounts receivable is an accrual, no? Accrual din yan matatawag. Kasi we have earned income not yet received the cash. Ang prepaid expenses naman, prepayments sa cash, but still, no expenses incurred. So, we paid for the cash na wala naman palang expenses pa. So, but there is a outflow of cash, an outflow, no? So, prepaid expenses decreases cash, but does not change the net income. Hindi siya mag-change. Bakit? Na natin. Ang prepaid expense ay isang asset, no? Prepaid rent. Halimbawa, you pay the cash. So, makikita ba natin sa entry that it affected the net income? Hindi. Kasi only balance sheet accounts are affected. Prepaid rent is an asset and cash is an asset. So, this does not affect the net income. Pero, ang tanong, is this a cash flow? Yes, this is an outflow of cash. So, nagkaroon ng decrease in cash because there is an increase in prepaid expense. Yun yung titignan ninyo eh. Ang prepaid expense, itinan mo sa balance sheet or sa given problem, is it an increase or is it a decrease? When we say it is an increase, nasa debit ang prepaid rent because nasa credit ang cash. If big trend is increase, and then the cash is decreased. So there is a cash outflow, but no change in income. So yung income na yan, na hindi gumalaw doon sa ating presentation under indirect method, net income deduct the amount of the increase of prepaid rent because that means you paid the cash. Okay, no? So, increase pa rin ang pinag-usapan natin. Increase in prepaid rent, increase in accounts receivable, i-deduct natin sa net income. Magkaiba ang reason, no? Itong accounts receivable, kaya natin dinidact ang increase ng accounts receivable because that is a non-cash transaction. Pero, it affected the net income. It increases the net income. While the other one, increase ulit sa asset, current asset, but now, this is a cash transaction that does not affect the net income. Magkabiba, no? Yung isa naka-apekto, yung isa hindi. Yung isa, non-cash, pero ito namang prepaid ay cash flow. So, balik-balikan ninyo yung discussion about it. Now, let's go to the current. Sample lang ito. Now, we have the decrease naman tayo. Decrease in current assets. Balikan natin si accounts receivable. This time, when we say decrease in current assets, we have to add back to net income yung decrease ng current assets dito sa ating formula, ha? Yung sa taas. Now, accounts receivable, no? Pag nag-decrease, tanong ko muna sa inyo, when do we decrease the accounts receivable? When we have collections. Diba? Bumababa lang naman talaga ang accounts receivable when we have collections. Kaya tumataas ulit. Ang accounts receivable ay nag-i-increase kapag may sales on account. So, yung dalawa na yun, dapat din natin nakakalimutan. So, accounts receivable, pag nag-decrease, increases cash. Of course, you receive the cash for your collections. Diba? Lagay ulit natin. Cash is debit. Kasi na-receive mo yung ano eh, bayad ng customer, then the AR would be debited, credited. Sorry. So, is this transaction affects the net income? No, it does not change the net income. It increases your cash, yes. It is a cash inflow, yes. Pero hindi niya na-apektuhan si net income. Because we are reporting for the cash flow, we should add back the decrease in accounts receivable sa net income. You know, no? Laging titingnan, naka-apekto ba? Hindi ba naka-apekto sa net income? Cash flow ba? Hindi ba cash flow? Kapag sigurado kang cash flow at hindi naka-apek sa net income, kung ano man yung nangyari sa cash inflow, i-add back mo. Pag outflow, i-deduct mo naman. Okay. So, dito naman, decrease in prepaid expense. O, kailan naman tayo nagbababa ng prepaid expense natin? We are just entering the transaction at the end of the period by way of adjusting entries, di ba? So, yung prepaid expense na yan, para bumaba, ay kinikredit natin. Sabi sa inyo, pagka cash flow, medyo mahirap dahil pa, balikan natin yung mga accruals, prepayments, deferrals. So, yung prepaid expense na yan, yung prepaid rent, halimbawa, ikikredit natin para mag-decrease. And ano yung mag-debit? We have the rent expense. Hindi ka tumatanggap ng pera ulit doon sa una mong binayad. We debit the rent expense. And we credit the prepaid rent. Kung may cash bang gumalaw, there is no cash flow. Pero, it has an expense that decreases the net income. So, anong gagawin natin? This is a non-cash transaction. Kung dating nagpababa sa net income, ano na, idadagdag ulit natin. Kaya sabi, decreasing current assets, add to net income. So, yun pa lang, pag-decrease ng prepaid rent, meaning ay mayroon nang naging expenses for the period, end of the period, that affects the net income. So, this is a non-cash. So, yung kung ano man yung ibinawas, i-add back sa net income. Nakaka-follow ha? Are you following? So, dito naman tayo sa increase in and decrease sa liability. I hope na susundan nyo. Patiin natin because we are now sa liability. Increase in current liabilities, add back to net income. Added to net income. Ito yun, no? Current liability, pag increase, increase din sa net income. Pag decrease, decrease din sa net income. So, let's have an example. For the accounts payable, when we increase accounts payable, yun yung pinaliwanag ko kanina, una pa lang, increases expenses, kaya nga may accounts payable because you have no cash payment. Laging ganun. You increase the expenses kasi you increase your accounts payable kapag may expenses, kung wala kong cash. Okay. This decreases the net income because nga may expenses eh. So, increase in accounts payable decreases the net income. But, it is not a cash transaction. So, meaning, kung may expenses ka na hindi naman cash, i-add natin ulit sa net income. No? Now, another one, unearned income. So, these are the perals, no? Unearned income are income received. Yung cash daw na received but not yet earned. Kaya nga, unearned. So, meaning, may increase ka nga ng cash kasi may cash received. But does not change the net income. Ay, ano ba nangyari dyan? Diba? O, i-debit ulit natin. Debit cash, na-receive mo yung cash, at nagkaroon ka ng unearned. Unearned rent. Rent na naman, ano? O, diba? We have cash transaction. But, this is a liability account, not an income account. So, it doesn't affect the income. But, this is a cash flow. Huwag niyo kalilimutan, cash flow statement tayo. So, lahat ng inflow, galaw ng cash, outflow, ay isama natin, include natin sa statement ng cash flow under operating activities. At kanino natin i-add back or i-deduct doon sa income statement. Kasi, doon kay net income because the net income is the item that we are reconciling, no? Yan. Kasi sa net income tayo nag-start, no? Dito tayo nag-start sa net income. So, dito natin idadagdag o ibabawas yung mga binabanggit natin transactions that affects or not affect, no? No effect, may effect, pero cash flow ba or non-cash flow ba? So, again, the unearned income, we receive the cash, but we have only the liability, not the income. So, ang effect niyan ay mag-add sa net income ng amount ng in-increase ng unearned income. When you say, kasi ang tinitignan natin, yung increase-decrease ng current liabilities at saka ng current assets kanina. Hindi natin sinasabi increase-decrease ng cash, hinahanap nga natin kung may cash flow dyan eh. So when we say nag-increase ang unearned rent, ako ano ibig sabihin nun? Dapat bigla, in an instance, alam nyo na kapag nag-increase ang unearned rent, ay may na-receive tayo kasing cash dyan. So that is a cash transaction, but does it affect the net income? Isama sa presentation under operating activities. I-add back, i-add sa net income. No? Doon din accounts payable. Bakit nag-increase ang accounts payable? Because hindi tayo nagbayad ng utang. Hindi tayo nagbayad ng expenses. So may expense. Ang expense pala ay nakapagpababa sa net income. Eh, hindi naman cash. So, i-add natin sa net income. Presentation tayo pagdating sa physical classes, sa decreasing current liabilities. O again, why do we decrease our accounts payable? Bakit nagkakaroon ng decrease in accounts payable? Because there is payment of accounts payable. Diba? So there is a cash outflow. Pagka nag-decrease ang accounts payable, nagbayad sigurado ng cash. So it decreases the cash, but again, does not change the net income. Sulat ulit natin para makita. Ang accounts payable ay gini-debit natin when it is decreased, no? Then we pay for it, kaya nga nag-decrease. So meaning, this transaction is only recorded in the balance sheet. No effect on the income, but this is a cash flow, no? Outflow. So, pag lumabas yun, kaya nga deduct. Ay, naku, I hope you can follow. Now, the unearned income naman, oh, decreased naman in unearned income, again, like the prepaid expenses. Bakit bumababa ang unearned income? Iyan ba ay may binalik ba tayong cash or what? Bakit bumaba ang liability? Liability to ha, yung unearned income. So, ang liability income, ay, liability account, which is the unearned income, ilagay natin sa debit para makita nyo na ito ay nag-decrease. Yung mga hindi maka-follow, please, magbasa na magbasa. Unearned income. And then, sa adjusting interest lang natin nakikita yan. So, we have now the earned income, rent income. Palaging rent, favorite. Unearned rent. No? Unearned rent. So, we have, again, a transaction that is a, not a cash flow. This is a non-cash transaction. Wala. May nakita ba tayong cash? Wala. But there is already an income that increases the income. There is already a revenue. Rent income will increase the net income. Pero may cash ba? So this rent income is included in the net income. Pero dahil hindi siya cash, ibabawas natin yung nadagdag sa net income. Kaya naman, decrease in current liability in an earned income, i-deduct din natin sa net income. Marami pa iba. Okay. So this is only the portion or the part of the operating activities in presentation of cash flow. So dito sa ating investing and financing, hindi naman yan mababago na. Okay? So next nating pag-usapan ay paano ba natin, ano ba ang principle behind this? Paano natin nakikita na that amount is increased or decreased and added or deducted to the net income? Okay, next video naman tayo.